Hello students, let us continue the session on revision of the chapter Areas Related to Circles. In the previous session, we had discussed till question 11. Let's continue from question 11. The 11th one is the area of the largest circle that can be drawn inside a rectangle of length a centimeter and breadth b centimeter, where a is greater than b is pi b square. Here the diameter of the circle can be drawn inside a rectangle is equal to the breadth of the rectangle. Let me mention that the diameter of circle that can be drawn inside the rectangle is equal to the breadth of the rectangle. Let me consider the length to be a units and breadth to be b units. The diameter will now be b units. This implies that the radius will be half of the diameter, b by 2 centimeters. Therefore, the area will become equal to pi r square. Now, in the place of r square, I need to substitute b by 2 whole square. This becomes 1/4 of pi b square centimeter square. So, 1/4 is missing here. So, the given statement is false. Twelfth one, the circumferences of two circles are equal. Is it necessary that their areas will be equal? Here, let me consider R1 to be the radius of one circle, R2 to be the radius of another circle. So 2 pi R1 equal to 2 pi R2 because their circumferences are equal. This implies that R1 will be equal to R2. Let me consider R1 equal to R2 to be R. Now, if I consider the ratio of their areas A1 by A2, this will be equal to pi R1 square by pi R2 square. This will become equal to pi R square by pi R square. They all get cancelled. We'll be getting equal to 1. This implies the area of first circle and the area of second circle, they are equal. So the given statement is a true statement. Statement number 13. Areas of two circles are equal. Is it necessary that their circumferences are equal? Like the previous one, we have to equate now to the areas. So R1 I'll consider as radius of the first circle and R2 to be the radius of the second circle. This implies R1 square will be equal to R2 square. This implies that R1 and R2 be equal. I'll take them to be equal to say R. Now I'll consider the ratio of the circumferences C1 by C2. This will be 2 pi R1 by 2 pi R2. This will be equal to R1 by R2 because 2 pi 2 pi they get cancelled. Since these two are equal to R, R by R equal to 1. This implies that C1 will be equal to C2. The given statement is again a true statement. 14th one. Is it true to say that area of square inscribed in a circle of diameter p centimeter is p square centimeter square? Why? The diameter of the circle is p centimeter. Let me call d as a diameter. It is p centimeter. Here, AC square will be equal to the square of AB plus the square of BC by Pythagoras theorem. Here, AC is P square. This will be equal to AB square plus, instead of BC square, I'll again consider AB square. The reason is it's a square. The adjacent sides are equal to each other. So AB square plus AB square is 2 times AB square, so I get AB as P upon root 2. This is the relation obtained in a square. Now area of the square will be equal to the side square. This will be equal to P upon root 2 multiplied to P upon root 2. This will be equal to P square by 2 centimeter square. Therefore, the given statement, they have given that it is P square centimeter square, it is false. Therefore, the statement is false. Let's now take exercise 11.3. These are short answer type questions. First, we have find the radius of the circle whose circumference is equal to the sum of the circumferences of the two circles of radii 15 cm and 18 cm. Here I'll call circle 1 as C1. This has got a radius 15 cm. Circumference of second circle, I'll call it as C2. This has got a radius 18 cm. The combination of these circles, I'll call it as circle C. It has got the radius we need to find, because the question find the radius, right? So according to the question, we have the sum of the circumferences of the two circles equal to the circumference of the third circle. This implies that 2 pi r1 plus 2 pi r2 equal to 2 pi r. Here 2 pi is being common and it gets cancelled, and we are left with r1 plus r2 equal to r. So the radius of the new circle will be 15 plus 18. Which is 33 centimeter. Second question, in the figure 11.5, a square of diagonal 8 cm is inscribed in a circle. Find the area of the shaded region. Here, let me draw the diagonal. This diagonal will be same as the diameter. Let me name this as square ABCD and the center of the circle as O. Let me take A to be the side of the square. So I have considered side of square to be A centimeter. So the radius will be OA, this is half of AC, so we get 4 centimeter. If you observe, we have got a right angle triangle. So in triangle ABC, we have AB square plus BC square equal to AC square. So A square plus A square equal to 8 square. So twice a square will be equal to 64. This implies that a square is equal to 32. Now, area of shaded portion, area of shaded part will be equal to area of circle minus area of square. Area of circle is found using the formula pi r square, and a square is the area of square. So it is 22 upon 7 into 4 into 4, because the side, sorry, radius is 4, minus 32. Let's simplify now. Here it is 16, here it is 16 times 2. So I can take out 16 as common. If 16 is taken common, we'll be left with 22 upon 7 minus 2. So if 16 taken common, we get 22 upon 7 minus 2. Here the LCM is 7, so 22 minus 14 we get, which is 8 by 7. So we'll be getting 128 upon 7. Upon simplification, we'll be getting 18.27 approximately centimeter square. Sorry, centimeter. This is centimeter square because it's the area. Third one, find the area of a sector of a circle of radius 28 centimeter and central angle is 45 degree. Let me take a rough figure of a circle wherein O is a center. I'll name these two points as AB. For convenience, I'll take this as P. This is theta. Let R be the radius. Here the radius is 28 centimeter. The central angle they have given as 45 degrees. So the area of sector, let me name the sector OAPBO. This is a sector. This area will be equal to pi r square by 360 degree into theta. So we get 22 upon 7 multiplied to 28 into 28 radius square into the central angle is 45 degree divided by 360 degree. Here 7 4 times is 48. Into 8 will be 360. So 4 ones are 4 2 times. So 2 11 times. Finally, we get 11 multiplied to 28. This will be equal to 308 centimeter square. This is the area of sector. Fourth question. The wheel of a motorcycle is of radius 35 centimeter. How many revolutions per minute must the wheel make so as to keep the speed of 66 kilometer per hour? Here let me consider the speed of the wheel. With the letter V, this is equal to 66 kilometer per hour, which is nothing but 66 multiplied to, I'll convert this in terms of meter per second. I know the conversion. I need to multiply 5 by 18. This will be equal to 55 upon 3 meter per second. Radius of the wheel is 35 centimeter. I'll convert this in terms of meter. It is 0.35 meter. Here I need to find the number of revolutions for the time. 1 minute, I'll consider 60 seconds. So I need to find the number of revolutions as v into t, speed into the time, divided by 2 pi r. Here it is 55 by 3 into 60 divided by 2 into 22 upon 7 multiplied to 0.35. On further simplification, it becomes 55 times 60, this denominator's denominator, 7 multiplied to this 0.35. I'll write as 35 by 100, so 100 divided by 3 into 2 into 22 into 35. Just simplify, we'll be getting it as 500 revolutions in a minute. Question 5. A curve is tied with a rope of length 14 meter at the corner of a rectangular field of dimension 20 meter into 16 meter. Find the area of the field in which the curve can graze. Actually, it would look like this if I consider this as a rectangular lawn. In this lawn, if the curve is tied at the corner using a rope, it would cover the distance, which is equal to this particular distance, and it forms a sector. The area in which the curve can graze will be equal to area of the sector. So I need to find area of sector. Area of sector is given by theta by 360 degree multiplied to pi r square. Here, what is the angle? The angle here is 90 degree because it's a rectangular lawn. So it is 90 upon 360 degree multiplied to 22 by 7 into the radius is 14. Because the length of the rope will be same as the radius here. So it is 14 multiplied to 14. Further simplify, we'll be getting 154 meter square. So the curve can graze the area equal to 154 meter square. You can note this question, question number 6. You can try it out. I'll be discussing the answer of this particular question in the next video. You can cross check. If you find, you'll be getting 380 plus 25 pi centimeter square as the area of the flower bed. You can try this out. We'll be recalling, we'll be solving this question again in the next session. That's all for today's session. Thank you.